Shren on the tube, bigkidreviews.com, and some others sometimes. Today I'm going to replace a bulb, the signal bulb on the left side of this 2017 Chevy Express van, a one ton, quit working, and they didn't make it very easy to get to it. But then in some respects it is easy compared to some of the things I try to do. But what you got to do is see over here on this side. Now this one's got a lot of gap here, but you got to take up these bolts here and here for the lens. But for sure you got to take this one out and that top one out for this trim panel. And then you got to coerce it off of there. And I've seen videos where they say you slide it up and pivot it out. Well, not so much on this one. On this one, they've changed it and have these little nylon press in, press pull out things that almost always break. And they go in this holes here and here. So once you get the thing off of this bolt up here and this bolt up here, you need to go around on that side with a screwdriver and pry gently up. Don't try that twisting stuff like the other people say on the tube, because you'll end up breaking something. So, and after you do that, this one bolt here has to come off, because this light, the top lens, has to go there. And then of course you'll know the bulb, it's the Bayonet, the common 3157 is the one that went out. It's the signal light, and it's also the one that flashes when you use your key fob to open and lock the door. Alright, so I got it off finally, got the bulb replaced. And before you put it back together, test it to make sure it works. You can just hit the lock or the unlock button and that bulb will flash. And take your hanky or something, or wear gloves. They say on these bulbs that get hot, they'll burn out quicker if you touch them and leave a fingerprint. I don't know, I wiped it down with my handkerchief. I'm gonna have to put the camera down and plug them back in, then I'll set it up there and start a new clip. Setting up there, a little bit hard to start these. Now that top bolt's a little bit loose, but down here on the bottom there's a little stud sticking up. You need to be sure that this is sitting in there, and you don't want to loosen that top nut, because if you do, then this is slotted and you'll get it all out of catawampus. It'll be too hard to put back together. Too much experimenting. If you leave it like that, then wherever this falls up here, that's going to be where it's got to go. And these are pretty much limited. They don't have much move at all when they get tightened down. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten them down, then I'll come back and install that top part. And also, when you get it plugged in, check that thing again. Make sure you got the bulb in the right socket. The up here is where the signal light is, and that the one that burned out, and that's also the one that flashes when you use your key fob. All right, we'll be back on the next clip. One thing, you cannot put this bolt or cap nut back on here until you get this piece on. I may have said put this one and this one in, but can't do that. This has got to go on top of it. So got those back in, snugged it, and it took no pressure at all, which is very, very scary to put that back. That, you know, that scares me when it's that easy. But looking at the gap here and on the other side, a looks about the same to me. So the only thing left to do is to get the key out and hit the lock or unlock button. Fumble around here, I'll get it. All right, so it's working. And just to be sure, I'll check the signal light, but I'm sure it's working now. All right, that's all I got. It's a lot easier to do stuff when you know what you're dealing with than just trying to figure it out as you go, because like I say, the other videos I'd seen says you rock that thing out to unlock it and roll it out of some holes. Well, if you do that, you're going to break those little tabs off. So if you got a 2017 GMC or Chevy, don't do that. Do what I said to do. And hit that like and subscribe and all those good things. And click on that bell icon to be sure you're subbed. I got a whole lot of videos that I've had to turn private. I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to give you back access to all those videos I made, the hunting videos and stuff. But I'm still working on it. Getting old, doing stuff around the place, trying to keep up with the grass bird population and take care of my animals. It's taking most of my time, and then the rest of the time seems like I'm going to the doctor. All right, big kid out. See you on the next video, and God bless and take care, everybody.